Back to my channel, Make Easy. This is the second video of file handling in QBasic, and today we are going to solve one QBasic program of file handling. That is, write a program. As you can see, this is RAME. RAME is used to write the comment in the program, like I have written here, program name. And few questions which we'll discuss in this video. WAP stands for write a program in QBasic to input roll number, name, class, mobile number of some students. It is not mentioned here like 5 students, 10 students or 15 students. So some students, I have explained that how you can do for exact number of students like 5 or 10 or 2 or 3 or 4. In the previous video, you can watch that. It is mentioned some students. And store these information in sequential data file. File name is student.dat. This is extension. This is data file extension. So we have to take input for this information and we have to store this information in this file. Now, let's start the code. First of all, always we write the CLS to clear the data of the output screen. And then we'll open the file to store the data. File name is mentioned there, student.dat. Or output. We discussed about the output mode in previous class that is used to store the data in the file. This open student.dat will open the file and create this new file student.dat to store the information. This #1 will represent this file. Whenever we want to write this name student.dat, we can write this #1. Okay, file is open, student.dat. Now what we need first of all roll number. So we'll write here input. Okay, before that we have to use do while loop here because it is mentioned here some students, so we need to use do while loop. Do input enter roll number, then roll number will be stored in R. Then after that what we need is name. Enter name. I will store that name in $ because this is string. Then mobile number, enter class C because class will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 or that number. So last is enter mobile number. Enter mobile number M has. Always remember, if you want to store the numbers which contain 7 or more than 7 digits, then you have to store that in M has. This is called double type variable. This is numeric variable. This is double type variable. So it can store more than 7 or more than 7 digits because mobile number contain 10 digits. So this variable can store 1 digit, 2 digit, 3 digit, but it can store 7 and more than 7 digits of number. So we have taken the input. So now we want to store this information in file. Which file? Student.dat. So it is represented by #1. So write statement is used to store the data into the file. So which file? #1 file. This is student.dat. What are the information? R for roll number, as it is mentioned here, $N for name, and then C for class because we have used here C, and then M has for mobile number. It is stored in the file. Now we have taken the input for one user or one student because it is mentioned now some students, so we are using do while loop. Now after storing this data into the file, we'll ask user, do you want to continue or do you want to store more record? Do you want to store more records? Then user will enter yes or no. So let's give option. You have to press Y or N, yes or no. So this is character, so we'll use here again C $ because this is character. So after storing, we are asking user, do you want to store more information? So user will press Y or N. Then we have to use loop while. Loop while u case dollar c dollar equals to capital Y. Done. So what does it mean? We are asking user, do you want to continue? User will press Y or N, like this one. User can press small y and small n, or user can press capital Y or capital N also. So whatever user will enter, we are checking that. Loop while u case dollar of c dollar. So user can enter capital Y, small n, capital N. We are converting that into the capital letter using this u case dollar. So if user have pressed this Y, small y, it will be converted into the capital Y using this UK's dollar, and we are checking that whether it is capital Y or not. If it is capital Y, then we are using loop. It will go here again to the do, and it will ask user to enter the values and store it again. And again after storing, we are asking user again, do you want to continue? So if user will press N, then it will be converted into the capital letter capital N, and we are checking whether it is Y or not. If this is not Y, user is saying no, I don't want to store any information, then it will go to the next line and close the file. Close as one, and then end up the program. So this is how it works. Let's run the program. Before running, let me show you the folder where this file will be stored. Look, this is my C drive and QB64. Let me show you again. If you want to install this QB64, you can install it. I will provide link in the description. Go to your C drive where it is stored, like installed, QB64 folder. As you can see, the file will be created here. Now I will make this little bit small in size, and I will show you simultaneously how file will be created. Okay. Now as you can see, I'll go to the file option. Let me save this program. I'll give name output mode. Whenever I will press OK, the output mode program will be saved in this folder. Now you can see output mode.bas. This is the program, whatever we have written there in the QBasic. Look, this is what program file I mentioned. What is program file? This is program file where we have written the code. And next, after running the program, as you can see here, I have mentioned this student.dat. This is what data file, where are these information will be stored, not the code, this information. So after running the program, go to the run option, start, or you can press F5. After doing that, look, after doing this, you can see output screen where we can enter the values. Roll number, I will enter 12, name, easy, then class, and mobile number, I will enter just random number. Look at, after entering this information, it is asking, do you want to continue? I'll press yes, I want to continue. Again, look, this is asking for roll number because I have pressed Y, and it is true. Then it will go up and ask for the second record or second user information. I'll enter 13, name, and then class, and then mobile number. Done. Again, it is asking, do you want to continue? I will say no, I don't want to continue now. Press enter. After pressing enter, as you can see, as you noticed, student.dat is created. This is what data file. Let me go to this program. As you can see, I have mentioned here student.dat, where I want to store information. So this student.dat is created. You can see the time, just now it is created. I'll double click on it. As you can see, this information is here. So this is what data file. You can open this in this way. If you are getting problem, go to open with and select notepad to open this, and you can see the data. This information is stored here. So this is what use of the output mode. And look, again, if you want to run the program, the old data will be deleted from this student.dat, because output mode will delete the previous data or old data and store the new data. Let me enter roll number 1. I will write name Mick only and class 10. Mobile number. Yes. Do you want to continue? Yes, I will enter next. Then name. First one is Mick. Second one is Mick easy. Now 10. Then mobile number. Done. Do you want to continue now? I will say no. I don't want to continue. Capital N, small N, you can enter. Just done. Now student.dat is here. Double click on it and check. Now you can see this old data is deleted. Only we have new data. So this is how output mode works in file handling. So now you are clear about what is data file, what is program file. So thank you for watching. If you understood this program, please click on the like button, click on the subscribe button, and just comment below if you have any confusion. In the next video, I'll explain you how you can use append mode. And then after that, I will explain you input mode programs. Have a great day.